Hello everyone. In today's video, I will talk about the use of paired sample t-test and how you can use it to test the hypothesis. Independent sample t-test is also known as the dependent sample t-test. This test is used to find the mean difference between two sets of variables. Here lies a slight difference with the t-test and the ANOVA. As I have already made a dedicated video on how and when to use the t-test and ANOVA, and if you want to more detail about t-test and ANOVA, you can check the videos. The link is provided in the description box. Now, to do this analysis, if we have a question like what is the impact of training on the performance of employees? It means if we want to find out whether the training is of any benefit in the performance of our employees or not. There are lots of questions in the mind of the organization when they provide training to their employees. They want to make sure that these training programs are of any importance, or are they really going to benefit their employees in terms of performance? Which means they want to find out whether these training programs are improving their performance in the job or not. So if we have a hypothesis that there is no significant difference of training on the performance of our employees, we can test this hypothesis with the use of paired sample t-test, and we'll also be utilizing the t-test and ANOVA for this hypothesis. Now, if we have a data set where we have collected the data of the performance of employees before training, which is recorded here in pre-training column, and the performance scores after the post-training. Now, in this column, this is the data view. If you click here, variable, you will find there is values column. In values column, I have mentioned here 0 as no training and 1 for the training. For this program, what we have done, we have selected one group of employees and the data was recorded, the scores were recorded before providing any training to any of the employee. And later on, some of the employees were selected and they were provided the training to measure if there is any impact of training on their performance. So this means from the same group, we are collecting data two times. One, before providing the training, and second time after providing the training to the selected number of employees. Now, the first step is go to transform, compute variables, and try to find out if there is any difference in scores before training and after training. So we will make another column with the name difference, and in numeric expression we will say post training minus pre training, that is the difference. When we click OK, we'll get one more column with difference. So this column will be used to find out the significant difference in the performance of our employees before training and after training. Now, to do this analysis, what we will do, first we will try to find out is there any difference in the performance of employees before and after the training. For this, we will go to analyze, compare means and paired sample t-test, and here in paired sample t-test it will ask what is the variable 1, like what you want to measure. Here we will select display variables. Pretest is the first. Second is posttest. This means we want to compare the scores of the employees, same employees, before providing the training and after providing the training. Just click OK and you have the output. And you will find the mean scores. There is a huge difference. Performance 1 is pre-training. The mean score is very low. And performance 2 is post-training. Mean score is very high. This means that there is a change, or you can say there is a difference in the performance of employees post-training. And this change is significant. You can check significant level from here. So this complete group, in this group, you remember I told you we are not providing training to all the employees. So if we give training only to some employees, selected employees, then also the performance of the total group increases. Now what we have to do, if we have one query in our mind to know what happens to those employees who are provided with the training. So what we will do, go to data, we will select cases, if condition, if we provide training is 1. Select cases only with training, like what I'm saying that select only those employees to whom I have provided the training. So what is the impact of training on the employees? We can directly find it out from here. So here it is selecting only those employees which have been provided some training with 1, and rest for 0 it has crossed, or it will not include in the analysis. Now we can easily find out what happens only to these employees. So to these employees, we will again go to analyze, compare means, and we will go to paired sample t-test. These groups are same, pre-test and post-test. Click OK. Now in the output you will find there is a significant increase in the mean scores of before and after. Before providing the training and after providing the training, from 66 it is going to 239, and it is significant. Okay, so this figure is only for those employees, 120 employees, for which we have provided the training. This figure earlier it was for 245, means all the employees. What happened to all the employees if we provide training to a certain number of employees? Here also the mean score increased. Okay, so this means if we provide training, the overall performance of all the employees increases. Yes, and the performance of those employees for which we have provided the training, the mean score also increases, and it is also significant. Now what we will do, let's check what happens to those employees for which we have not provided the training. Now if training is equal to 0, what will happen to that? Click OK. Now here we are selecting only those employees to whom we have not provided the training. By clicking this, you will find the data for those employees who have been provided training is crossed. This means this will not be included in our analysis. We will include only those employees who have not been provided any training. We'll go to analyze, compare means, paired sample t-test, This is saying click OK and you will get the output. Now here in output, you find that this output is saying, yes, the performance is increasing even for those employees who have not been provided any training, which means that the same employees, when they are asked to repeat the task, their performance increases. So here you see in all the three cases, for those employees, this is for total. This is for total, means all selected employees are provided training, but the overall performance is increasing. Here, the selected employees have been provided training and their performance is increasing. And the third case, these employees have not been provided training, but still their performance is increasing. Even without training, you find that their performance is increasing. Now, what could be the reason? The one reason is that when you ask the same employees to repeat the task, their performance increases because they are doing the same task again and again, which means the efficiency level will increase. So it is clearly seen here. But when we provide training, the mean score is increasing at a higher rate, from 66 to 239. Without training, it is increasing, but at a lower pace, from 71 to 177. Now you can test this in one way, one click. Now instead of going for the select cases, what you can do, go again to select case, reset, OK, and now all the data will be included, no data is crossed. What we will do, data, you split the file. Instead of select cases, you can do that analysis in one go. Select cases and here compare groups. So what type of groups you want to compare? I want to compare related to the exposure to the training. Hit OK and you have two groups. Now go to analyze, compare means paired sample t-test, before and after, click OK. So you have the output. You have the output here, both the data is available in the same table. See, this is for the group which has not been provided with the training data, 71 and 177. You see here 71 and 177, and this data for those who have been provided with the training, 66 and 239. You can check that, 66 and 239. So this means you can perform this task in two ways. One is by doing the select cases, or individually directly by selecting and splitting the same file into two groups. And in this way, you can perform this task. And here the output is significant. So which says that the increase in the performance of the employees who have been provided with the training is also significant, and the performance of employees who have not been provided training is also significant. So this means both are significant and increasing. Now in this data, we are not able to know whether this significant increase is significantly different in both the group or not. So for that analysis, what we will do, again we will go to data, we will go to split file, we don't want to split the file, click OK. Now This time we will use compare means, and you have two options. Either you can select the independent sample t-test, or you can go for ANOVA because you want to find out whether the difference is significant or not. If you select independent sample t-test, I'll do both ways one by one. I want to select differences here because I want to know whether this difference is significant across the two groups, which is the providing the training or not providing the training. So click OK, you'll get the output. Now it is saying in the t-test, it is saying that yes, it is significant. So the difference in the performance is significant, and from the paired sample t-test we have known that it is increasing. So both the things have been tested, that there is a significant difference in the group of employees who have been provided the training and the group of employees who have not been provided the training. Secondly, these differences are studied in detail, and we have found out that there is a significant increase in the performance of both these groups. And the increase in the performance of that group which has been provided the training is greater than the increase in the group without training. Now, there is one more output in the table, which is Levin's test of equality of variance. And here it is insignificant. So this figure should be insignificant because homostaticity of the data should be checked. If it is significant, we have a problem. We want it to be insignificant. So to be insignificant, it should be more than 0.05, which is good for this test. Now let's go and see what will happen if we go for the ANOVA. Go to analyze, compare means, one way ANOVA. And here we are selecting dependent variable as a difference, exposure to training as the factor. Let's go for descriptive and mean plots. Click OK. You will get the output. And the output is saying there is a significant difference in the group of employees of the company which have been provided the training and without training. And this plot, mean plot, is showing that no training, the mean score is about 110 or so, and with training, see the output, the performance is increasing more than 170 or 175. So there is a huge difference. It is easily you can interpret, easily you can see from this graph. Okay, so it is very easy to understand using this graph. Now if you like the video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel for more such videos on EasyStats. Thank you for watching.